same one. Yeah, it's got its wiper blades on and everything. Yeah, that's the one I'm picking up. Yep. There we have it, people. There again. Here you are. 591. This is camera. Dirty bastard. Hey, people. See him there on the new camera. Got my jacket. What I'm gonna do is this time, because it's some downhill people that are getting clipped, I'm gonna go up the road a bit further and stick my sign out. Camera sign's missing. Took it out. Shit. Oh well, looks like I'll just pull in that car park for a few minutes.
Hey guys, as you can see, I'm here with my camera glasses on. And you can see the speed camera head sign there. So let's go for a walk down and record the bastards. Nice, I got him braking. 2 seconds my sign can't work, eh? All these brake lights on. Wonder why. Could it be that I'm parked there with a giant sign on top of my car saying speed camera ahead? But as I haven't recorded this one closely before, we're going to do that. Look at the truck. Even the trucks are braking. See? You don't need an arsehole in a van like that one up ahead of me. You just need a sign up the road. So he's sitting there with the engine running, I might add. How cheeky is that? Point out that these unmarked speed or safety vehicles, as they put it, these unmarked vans are collect between 3 to 5 times as many infringements per time they're out than the marked vans do. I can show you that when I get back to the car if you like, but it really is disgusting. Straight downhill. As long as they're on a straight road with 300 meters clearance, they can be parked. And yes, he is technically on a flat area, but you can see the downhill slope they all come down at. It's really just disgusting. Everybody's looking at the strange cunt. That looks like so much fun. See the new speed camera there behind you?
Yeah, it's in her way.
Yeah. It's in her way. Classic. She has to go around them. So yeah, EUR591. Do we pay for your petrol? It's a bit sad there. Currently running. Gosh. It's a shock. Our money's paying for that freak. You know that? But I'll point out all of the cars slowing down for me. Good on them. Better let this van know, seeing they pulled out before my sign. So what time are we looking at? 12:07. Well, 12:03. My watch is a few minutes fast. Letting them all know. Yeah, people might turn around and say, you want to watch, they don't do you for obstruction. See, unlike most people, and by that I mean the normal citizens, I've done my research. I don't record almost 4 years of speed, well, 3.5 years of speed cameras without doing my research. Official Information Act requests to the police and to the Treasury have proven what I talk about. $80 million last year, majorly from infringement notices. So, really disgusting. How much money? And you can see why. So they can sit in their cushy vans all day and make a packet of money from people doing absolutely nothing wrong. You might say, well, the road rules are there for a reason. Yes, they are. But they're not there for pricks like that to collect revenue for the Crown. Then it just goes into the Government Consolidation Fund, which is just a slush fund for all the politicians to have. $100,000 a year goes to the United Nations Drug Control Program. But I'll show you that as well. So, back at the car, sign's still up. Clearly it's working. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay. So, I'll take it my glasses are still working. Look at that. The police. Aren't they lovely? Okay, so here, static program. That's your static cameras. Now here is a schedule of the non-departmental revenue and expenses. This is page 88 of the New Zealand's police's annual review or budget review. This is the actual readings for 2014-15. They made $86 million. $100,000 of it goes to the United Nations Drug Control Program. Crown revenue, I'd like to point, they're also putting in 100, so they may be using that to hide what they're up to. You can see here on the actual figures of 2016, or the year to ending 2016, was 80 million, and they estimate this year, again, $86,400,000 to be making in infringements. Now, this is just my Official Information Act request, review of deployment registers, because when I asked them for the cameras I'd recorded, there was about 68, they supplied double ups. They supplied plate numbers for vehicles that were deployed in certain areas that didn't relate to the video footage they had. They would say that there was a marked camera in this area at that date, when my video clearly showed that wasn't correct. It was an unmarked vehicle. Alright, so they're trying to say that they're being fair, and whereas clearly they're getting their facts wrong. They also couldn't supply 10% of the deployment registers. So does that mean they've lost the file? Does that mean that if you question the ticket, they can't produce the deployment register and you get off the ticket? This is the overview of the police, and there's more scheduled. That's the same again. These is the spreadsheet that I've made of all of the cameras that I filmed throughout the 3.5 years. The dates, the deployment times, how long they were there for, and how many tickets they issued. Okay, this shows every speed camera that I personally recorded according to their deployment register. Okay, now I point out here, in 2013, marked and unmarked. Granted, I only started in October, but on this one here, unmarked, 2,384 cameras, infringements, versus the marked of 954. This one here, 2015, unmarked, 942 infringements versus marked, 22 infringements. Okay, and 2016, 869 on unmarked vehicles versus the marked of 154. Now these are all verifiable. I can verify them. My footage that I've recorded over the last 3 years verifies it. So you might say, okay, but isn't that annoying the police? Aren't you stopping them from doing what they should be doing? And this is from the Treasury, okay, Official Information Act request that I gave to the Treasury. And this is where they tell me that they can't give me the information, but if I look here, because it's now publicly accessible, and that's that page 88, okay? They say here also on the New Zealand Police website that they would prefer not to issue infringement notices. So they say. I'll just skip through all of my various law stuff here. It's all about recording police, parking, driving offences and penalties. Okay, so just here it says they start for infringement fees can range from $12 for parking up to an offence of $10,000. For speeding, $30 for the lesser ticket less than 10k over, and then up to $630 for speeds up to 50k. In other words, you can't double the speed limit in a 50k area or you're going to get your car taken off you. Now this is all about other bullshit, skip all that. Locations of their stationary fixed speed cameras with their GPS. What else do I have here? Nothing to do with that one. It's just a case law about towing. There's the police overview and how much they hope to make on those specific years. Okay. Some offences, we'll skip all that shit. Dog Control Act, megaphoning in public, that's a lawful thing. And why is it a lawful thing? Because in conclusion, the district court made an error of law in assuming a duty not to annoy when protesting. There is no such duty. So you can protest with a loudspeaker in New Zealand and there is no such duty for them to stop you. These are handy little sections of the Crimes Act 1981. Defence of your own movable property, i.e. your car, defence of your dwelling house, and defence of your land and building. You can use those as a defence against any trespasser. Police, here we are, Senior Constable. Well, that's just all to do with Neil many years ago. Petitions of Rights, Bill of Rights Act, always handy to have in case the cops don't know them. Freedom of expression, section 14, good to know. Section 18 is always handy, freedom of movement. And freedom of expression. Also, everyone has the right to freedom of expression, including the freedom to seek, receive, and impart information and opinions of any kind. In other words, record what you like. Okay. So, as you can see, I've done my research and woe betide any cop that wants to try and stop me and tell me off for doing what I do. So, moving on, I'm just going to go back out now and turn off the, take the sign down and carry on my mosey way. That's 20 minutes worth of people that aren't getting speed tickets. So, shit, you know, I've probably saved hundreds of dollars just sitting here with a sign. I thoroughly encourage everybody to do it. On the New Zealand Police website, they say that they would prefer not to issue infringement tickets. Excuse me. Right, gotta love the family, don't you? That's what I value in life. I don't value money, I value family, and that's what I can protect. Anyway. So how's that? I'll do the Pulp Fiction shit, man. I'll give you the Pepsi fucking challenge. Anybody that might actually have a set of balls out there, feel free. Stand there for 20 minutes, stick a sign up. These ass wipes here, this fucker right there, are making a shitload of money while they sit on their ass and leave their cars running. In fact, let's ring the police and ask them if it's an offence in New Zealand.
to leave your car running.
Parking. Supposed to have the name of the operator on the vehicle along with clearly marked contact details. Doesn't look like it. Anything wrong with the vehicle? Could be just a breakdown? Who knows? Well, the car's not broken down, not if he can drive it on there. They're going to leave them on the side of the road standing here, or if they're just going to be assholes. It's all about. Perhaps he was blocking someone's driveway. Alright, good on them, they're giving him a lift. They'll help you steer your car, but they'll still give you a lift elsewhere. Got any points for that one, I suppose, don't you? But you might call daylight robbery. Cool. Oh, you're kidding. Car seat and everything. So they're going to steal his car. Car seat, baby. Oh, unreal. That's really sad. Really is sad. Stolen. All because of revenue, people. Orphan stolen, eh? Let's see what it says about towing cars. Whoa, why don't you just pull out in front of the guy? Unbelievable. What's he gonna do? Is he gonna do a U-turn now and pull up behind me? I'm going to come across on this road. Wonder if the scumbag's still there, people. What do you reckon? He is or he isn't? Can't see along this flat until you get over the rise, and there he is. No toleration for them at all.